Today our presentation is paper plan. Firstly, I would like to introduce my group members. Bir Nazım Mustafa, Gülgar Ataşizade, and Orhan Nasıl, and me, Zahar Mehmet. And we are all of them business administration certificates. Firstly, I would like to give information about the producing papers in Azerbaijan. And we have investigated that there is no any CEO who has the chief of the paper manufacturing, and there is no any company that manufactures paper bags in Azerbaijan. This paper bags, we will collect the papers and we will do the recycling process. It's like the, using several times the used paper. this will, we will prevent the demand from the imported goods from the abroad, and at least we will start the production in Azerbaijan as top producer. Recycling process, and as we see, there has 5 main categories and 67 subcategories. And how we do the recycling process is it's like we collect the papers, we do a final process, and there will be some removing, and let's assume that we will lose 15% of that material. Let's say 1 ton if you refine, and about 15% of them, or 850 kilogram of paper you will get as a clean paper. And there is also other uses when we get doing the refining process or cleaning process. It's like on newspaper is production 15-20%, it's changed like that. And also in graphic papers, some even till 35%. There are two main reasons for which people would not to buy recycled paper. In an era of high rate of inflation, this low price range of products will affect people to purchase, because the price which we produce in Azerbaijan will be cheaper than imported goods. Second, recycled paper products are friendly to the environment, so we will be eco-friendly, and we can have the support from the some organizations or government structures. And this recycling process needs less energy, less water, and gets cheaper. We have some time. We have mainly we will produce paper bags, or we will it will be competitive in the market, which is our first competitor is the polyethylene bags or plastic bags. So we will at least we'll try to prevent this production and enter to the market. This is the graphic of world paper consumption, and as we see, there is a high demand, and day by day increases the demand, especially in America and Europe. The recycled paper is removed from the machine and is cut and shipped to the covered converting paper plant, where it will be printed or made into new paper products such as paper bags, envelopes, or boxes. In action of other firms, when we will produce these paper bags, other firms will get, will see that competitive, and they can decrease the prices of their own materials or goods like polythene or plastic bags to prevent our production. So we have to be ready on this. And personally, being businessman, we have considered the SWOT analysis, which are the from starting strengths, weakness, opportunities, and threats. Strengths are low price, environmentally friendly or eco-friendly, and low resource consumption and less garbage in the society. As we know, the paper can be refined about 3-4 times, and it rots no more than 1-2 years. Plastic or polythene bags are about 20-40 years. Opportunities, employment opportunities, we will get recruit new workers, and demand supply gap creates a room for our business, which is in power of the people we increase so they will cover our products. The weaknesses on the availability of machinery, we can get the difficulties to buy or to select the machinery correctly, and people may not accept this product if they don't properly market it, or poor resource to collect paper, to find paper threads. And other firms, as we know, can affect us negatively.
As we know that marketing is one of the
Can you speak louder, a little bit louder?
Yeah, as we know that marketing is one of the main part of our organizational function, and we divided marketing apart into a group, marketing concentrate on 4Ps and target market. As seen clearly, the marketing of 4Ps means first product and a consumer solution, which our product is created by. The second one, price and customer cost, third one is place and convenience, and fourth one is promotion and communication, which means advertising or conversion. Product and consumer solution, as I mentioned before, our product is paperback. The main reason so our business to produce a paperback is to preventing the air environment pollution. And when we produce a paperback, we predict that we will be supported by a government or other state departments. Same is price and customer solution. We guess that our price will be approximately 1 or 3 rupees. And our plan is to produce this simple paper bag, which means not to take more cost, and it will, we think that it will be good for us and for demander side because of its cheaper cost. And we guess that after our organization grows up to produce the very quality, a high quality a product with a high quality. And certainly, place and convenience. Place is so important for business size and demander side, so we decide to do our business in our own place. We settled in Sungai, and it's we settled in the main town of Sungai, Meshed as well, and it had very advantage because of it's surrounded by many big markets. And the first one is promotion and communication, which means advertising and commercial. Our plan is to make brochures and hand out to big markets, and after that to advertise it in public transportation. And the second part of our marketing is target market. Our target market is our markets, fast food restaurants, and grocery. You can ask us why your markets are target markets are markets, fast food restaurants, and groceries. Because of nowadays, our society go fast food restaurants often, and they are when they buy some foods from the fast food restaurants, and they are forced to carry it in a plastic, and it will cause them being ill, and it's also clear that the plastic packets are root. At least in 20 or 40 years. We have also a plan like that. We can, after our business growing, we can print the logos of markets and firms in our bank.
My department is operational management. As you know, our target markets are fast food restaurants, grocery, drugstore, and markets. And because of our target markets, our products are different. For example, paper bag of a drugstore is different from paper bag of fast food. And most important thing of our business is recycling process of papers. We collect papers from banks and colleges. These firms, they want to protect our nature or ecology, and recycle these papers and make paper bags. Not nature or ecology, because our first purpose is protecting our nature or ecology. We plan to buy a driver, another is a paper collector. In our building of firm, I mean our office building, we will have four employees. One of them is a cleaner, another is a mechanic, and two workers are responsible for our recycling process. And our assets, our building is cost is zero, and because of this our own building, car is 5,000 yen, equipment one machine 15,000 yen. Employee salaries, cleaner salary 200 yen, workers, top sum salary 250 yen, mechanics salary is 400 yen, driver is 300 yen, paper collector's salary is 250 yen. Just in time, no benefits of just in time, and we use it. Because if papers are sent lately to us, then it means our production process is stopped, and we can lose our trust. Once a week, we collect papers and we keep them in our warehouse, but every day we send our products to our customers, grocery markets, fast food restaurants, etc. They can come to our address and buy. It can be related to Sungai. Human resource management. For our business, we need only 6 employees beginning of our business. A hiring process of employees for cleaner, we don't need education. School education is not for cleaner. But we're looking for a trustable woman, don't steal anything or something like that. Cleaner age must be about 30 till 50 to agree 200 ASEAN for salary. We need only women, not men. Driver, also again, we don't need education, school education, not for a driver. But we're looking for a driver who has ability to drive, and his age must be about 25 till 45, and he has to have practice about 5 years and more. We need only not women. Workers who are responsible for recycling process, we need education, but only vocational school, and also ability to work with equipment. His age must be about 20 till 30. Paper collector, we don't need education, school education enough for paper collector. Also, we need a strong person because he must carry heavy boxes. His age must be about 18 till 25. Mechanic, we need education, university degree, and we need a great ability to understand equipment. His age is must be about 25 till 35. Sale process, every day we produce about 35 package, and each package has 100 paperback for beginning of our business, and we sell each package 2.5% because of size of paper bags, and the price also will be changed for future production.
First of all, I want to speak about our transactions. There are the investing to 24,000 mana. ASEAN, which the, each of us is paid, invested 6,000 mana, and this is calculated 24,000 mana. And after that, I want to speak about the second transaction. Second transaction is the salary expenses. The salary expenses, you know that in our company have six workers, and there are, each of them have wage. And we calculate that the monthly wage salary expenses hour is 1,650 ASEAN. And after that, there have equipment, and the first of all, the equipment is, there have two types of equipment, the machine, which produce the paper bag, and after that, there also have our car, which the cost is 4,000 man, but the machine cost is 15,000. And also there are utility delivery expenses. Delivery expenses is 150 mara. They include the oil which is use the car, and also petrol which gasoline maybe the car use. And they also have utility expenses. Utility expenses is 300 mara. They also include water. When we are selling the papers, we use water and energy. And also they have utility expenses and after that. Expenses and ingredient expenses also. Ingredient expenses. Ingredient expenses also include papers and the monthly papers we pay is 200 mark, and we don't pay this payment on the cash. We pay this payment on account. We will pay this payment next month. Next month, and they also have our revenue. We will produce the 35 package in every day, and this package include 100 paper bags, and our daily revenue is 887 mara, and the monthly our revenue is 2,625 mara, and also there are advertisement expenses. which we advertise our paper bag. This is include 125 mala. Our total assets is 24,400 mala, and also almost equity and liability is also equal. There also have some transactions. And also income statement. In our income statement, we calculated all these expenses for the monthly. There are revenue, our sales revenue, as can see. We also have expenses, other expenses, delivery expenses, utility, ingredient, advertisement expenses. And they also have the total expenses and net income. Net income for the first month we get 200 naira. And there also honest equity. Honest equity is we began our business in January 1 and so and there are investment. The investment is 24,000 mark, which both of us is paid 6,000 mark, and there also have include net income, which is 200 mark. We have calculated both of them, and we get capital January, end of the January, 24,200 mark, and there also have balance sheet. That include assets, cash and equipment. We are calculated the both of them and get total assets, and also the liability and bonus equity. We calculated the liability, which is have our account payable 200 mark, and bonus equity, our capital, and we get total liability and bonus equity. And so, thanks for